So one of the other things that's a fundamental building block of working with sound is something called octaves. And you may have heard of octaves before. We're going to talk about what these represent. And octaves are basically the summation of the sound over a certain frequency range, or the energy captured by the sound in a certain frequency range. And then we plot those on a special kind of axis. So essentially, I've got the noise curve up here. I'm saying group all of these amplitudes together, sum them up with an RMS sum, and report the value using this green bar, okay? And then I go up a chunk of frequency, and you notice this guy got a lot wider because there's actually twice as much frequency content that's being added together here to report for this green bar. And if I kept going up, there would be twice as much frequency information being summed together. So instead of plotting this on a linear axis like we have over here, we plot it on a logarithmic axis. It's where you see every tick mark that's equally spaced is actually doubling in frequency. Okay, so this makes all of our green bars the same width, but it's up to us then to remember that this green bar has twice as much frequency content summed together as this guy does. Okay, why do we do it this way? Well, this is what our brain does, okay? And so we pick these full octave bands, and again, acousticians like convenience, and so they picked 1,000 hertz, and it was a nice round number again, and they said, we're gonna, you know, cut the frequencies in half. They go higher in frequency, they double. And essentially what they're saying is, for this full octave band, 1,000 hertz bar, or the octave band at 1,000 hertz, will be the summation of everything from 710 hertz all the way up to 1,420 hertz. So notice if I go up an octave band, now it's twice as much information. This is roughly 700 hertz, right? This is now 1,420 to 2,840, roughly 1,400 hertz. So there's twice as much frequency information being summed together, okay? So they picked these numbers and these center bands out of convenience. But they said, well, this doesn't match really, really very well with how the human being hears lumps of frequency. So we divide each of those octave bands into thirds, and we get what we call the one-third octave band. You might recognize some of these frequency center bands because these are very often used in graphic equalizers. Okay, so our brain doesn't hear linear frequency, so we lump them together in these logarithmic octaves. That sort of mimics how our brain hears sound in terms of frequency.
Hey, Scott, did you break into my house and steal or get that picture?
I did. Pete is a audiophile, and so he's got some really nice equipment.
Yeah, analog equipment. You know, today kids just, you know, put it on their iPhone to get their little graphic equalizer, but nothing like the real thing with actual, you know, levers you can move up and down.
Yep. Do we have octaves in Test Lab?
Yes, we do have octaves, Scott. They're available under Tools Add-ins. And when you add them in, you can see them at the same time you're doing your narrowband measurements. So that's what I have here. The green bars are these octaves. And they are lumping the sound together in chunks, or however you describe that, over certain frequency ranges that get wider and wider as we go up in frequency. And if I was to do the whistle, you can see that, you know, the octave that contains that whistle goes higher in level. So if there was, you know, we hear the green, but if we had to diagnose the issue, we could figure out the actual frequency, like of the fan, if it's the fan blade versus the alternator versus a AC compressor or a pump, you know, those frequencies would show up. And there could be more than one tone or whatever making a particular octave band very wide. These get progressively wider. A lot of people, when they're looking at octaves, they like to look at it on an octave scale. They'll look at it like this, where they're equally wide, which I think is a little bit confusing. You know, the graphic equalizer looked like this too. You know, you don't know that, oh, this thing is actually a much wider frequency range at the higher frequencies than at the lower frequency range. So convention, a lot of people showed in octaves, but this is really what's going on behind the scenes. And again, really, our ear hears more like this. So that's probably because we're lumping together those chunks of sound.
Great. Thanks, Pete. So why do we use these octave bands? Well, the octave bands lump frequency together into chunks logarithmically. And we do this because this is kind of what our ear does. And we didn't get into it today, but the way your ear works, the organ that's inside is called the cochlea, and it produces this effect, okay? And so our brain hears these lumps of frequencies. It's sort of logarithmic in nature, and so we use octave bands to lump these frequencies in a similar manner, okay? So much like the decibel, it was sort of done for convenience because it's how we experience amplitude. Octaves are kind of a logarithmic way of how we experience frequency.